The reason you're the perfect person to join me for this trailer reaction is because I did the last one, which was a teaser reaction with Nadia, and it was it was interesting because she was a fan.
Okay.
But you are probably the biggest Marilyn Monroe fan I've ever known.
Yeah, well, I certainly was for a while.
Why was that? Why, what were you drawn to?
Well, you can't say that about Marilyn Monroe because she was so stunningly gorgeous.
No, but what was it about her story? Was it the death? Was it the story? Was it the intrigue?
Maybe the death first, in a way, and then when one went back and looked at her life, and yeah, she was so sort of, she was so unusual in that she was so innocent, you know, for all her being, you know, an amazingly curvy woman and having affairs with everybody you can possibly think of.
Yeah.
There was an innocence to her that stayed with her until she died.
And she, I mean, do you think she was
a good... Oh, this is going to be Joyce Carol Oates.
Yeah, this is Joyce Carol Oates' new film. Well, Blonde. It's the film based on Joyce Carol Oates' Blonde.
Blonde, yeah.
And what do you know about Joyce Carol Oates' Blonde? Because it's a fictionalised version of her life, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. I suppose she had to say that, didn't she?
Yeah. Have you read it?
No, I've got it, but I haven't read it.
Oh, right. So, I mean, in terms of Marilyn Monroe, though, is there something about her sort of particular type of star power?
She was one of these, they're very few and far between. Actually, they say the same about Elvis, the opposite way around, that Marilyn appealed to women and men,
right,
the way that Elvis appealed to women and straight men. I mean, they don't really know why. It's sort of something.
Well, I suppose if I think about why I'm intrigued by her, it's the idea that she's a victim. I always think of her in the same breath as being a victim, that she was manipulated, that she was she was the sort of victim of Hollywood treatment, the powers that be. But I mean, there was all the shady connections with Frank Sinatra, JFK, and then
Russians.
There was the Russians, then there was the sort of intellectual side, wasn't there? The Arthur Miller and all that side of things.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, this film called Blonde is causing a lot of upset. It's directed
by
a chap called Andrew Dominik, who did Killing Them Softly. I don't know if you remember that film, which I thought it was quite good, with Brad Pitt. Killing Them Softly.
Oh, yes, that was a good film.
Yeah, Ben Mendelsohn as well. It was a good film. He also made The Assassination of Jesse James by the coward Robert Ford.
Which is also a good film.
But in interview, Andrew Dominik has been extraordinarily angry in most interviews because, of course, this film, Blonde, that he's made, is being talked about. It's the first film to get an NC-17 rating for Netflix, which means it contains graphic sexual content.
Wow.
And it stars Ana de Armas, who we'll know, obviously, from... what's the name of the series?
But isn't she in The Grey Man?
Yeah, she's in The Grey Man. Yeah, she was in No Time to Die.
Yeah,
and she was also in...
Bond.
What's the bloody... Knives Out. She was also in Knives Out, of course. That's kind of important to a larger audience. Joyce Carol Oates. A lot of people also angry that this is being presented as if it's a biopic. But it's important to say that it isn't a biopic,
isn't
it?
No.
Yeah? So it picks up her traumatic childhood, tells the story of her life, and I think we're going to get an incredibly colourful and incredibly traumatic. Though this has been blighted with all sorts of negative press around the cut, around the edit, around screenings. Apparently there's been a lot of upset. Adrien Brody's in there as playing Arthur Miller. There's a lot of angst around this production.
Okay.
It hasn't been a happy production.
No.
And even the head of the Venice Film Festival, who I think is screening this, refused to say whether he thought it was good or not.
Oh.
Yeah, so, you know, we could be in for a curiosity.
Miss Monroe, it's time!
Get your start.
Baby.
What start?
In movies.
Quite continental. But diamonds are a girl's best friend.
I guess I was discovered.
Men broke homes as birds.
I know you're supposed to get used to it.
And we all lose our charms in the end.
I just can't.
Square cut or pear shape.
I played Marilyn Monroe. Marilyn Monroe. Marilyn Monroe. I can't face doing another scene with Marilyn Monroe. Marilyn doesn't exist. When I come out of my dressing room, I'm Normie Jean. I'm still her when the camera's rolling.
Diamond.
this on the screen.
Whoa. Ooh. I wonder if that's partly why it's got so much that she's in it. She's obviously saying that she can't take it anymore, what they're putting on her.
Mm.
And she never, as far as I know, did that in real life.
She never said it.
No, I mean, she never played it that way her life. She entered into it with gusto and say, instead she, of going home and dying, she took sleeping pills. I mean, she was a trooper in that respect.
But could there be an argument that perhaps the book and therefore the film is an articulation of something she perhaps, we would never have had any recorded notification or any recorded evidence of her saying this anyway, would we?
No, and I think that's very likely, because that's what Joyce Carol Oates does. That's how she writes. She'll inhabit the mind of the girl, of the woman, and then give us what she, you know, she thinks might have been the case.
But is it, yeah, I mean, and I suppose, yeah.
I'm going to read it immediately.
So yeah, I think it needs to be read, and I think we need to kind of know. I mean,
she's incredible. I mean, the first thing I was going to say, there's the very first shot, and I thought, oh, she doesn't look enough like her. I know that's not based all on impersonation. But then I couldn't tell what was her and what wasn't.
Well, what I liked about it as well was they used. I'm thinking of all the photographs you used to have all over the walls in our flat in Blenheim Crescent.
Yeah.
Her in a very, you know, the cardigan photo, the pool photo, the pink dress photo. They've recreated. I mean, it looks staggering.
Identical.
I mean, it looks stunning, and the black and white is really impressive.
Yeah.
You feel that you're. You know, I wonder. Does it matter if this isn't an accurate portrayal of what she actually felt? We can suppose and presuppose and wonder and entertain thoughts of perhaps she wasn't happy. I mean, let's not beat around the bush. She died in suspicious circumstances.
Yeah,
right?
Exactly. And at the very least, supposing she was. I mean, we don't know exactly how happy or unhappy she was, but the amount of tablets and drugs she took presupposes that she was not very happy.
Yeah, it's a safe bet she wasn't happy. So I think to entertain and fictionalise what might have been going on for her, I did like all that. You know, I'm always Marilyn Monroe. You know, I can't do Marilyn Monroe.
Yeah, no, I don't not like it, but I think that
do you think that's why it's called upset?
I think it might be. And also, Joyce Carol Oates, it's pointless to be saying this because I can't remember which book she did it in. She did a very similar thing with another iconic figure, where she went off on her own journey.
Sort of
with it.
Right, okay.
So.
Well, I thought that looked impressive. I thought it was beautifully shot, beautifully edited.
Amazing.
I mean, it took a bit of getting used to her voice, but I presume, I never, you know what? I can't think of what Marilyn Monroe's normal voice was.
It was that.
Yeah, well, there you go. Yeah, I'm really excited about that.
Yeah, and I mean, so often, even in tiny little clips, the one you always see is, you know, the one with Tony Curtis and...
Oh, yeah. Some Like It Hot.
Some Like It Hot. There wasn't a still of that, interestingly.
No.
But as you say, all the photographs, which I had, books and books, because Norman Mailer did a photographic essay on that.
Yes.
And it was those epic, iconic
photos.
Photos. She did one in the swimming pool that was supposed to be
the
last
naked.
Movie.
Yeah.
Identical, the sort of care that the director has gone and the team have gone to get that.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think she looks sensational.
She does look sensational.
I'm trying to work out why people are so angry, including the director.